those glasses. I'm so glad you're here to show me your glasses.
We're
like glass twins. Well, not really. I mean, because yours are red and mine are blue, but
I know,
you know.
But
I love it too.
Only that we look smarter.
Yes.
I look smarter anyway.
And we have our coffee. Because it's all about coffee on a Monday makeup chat with epic makeup Melissa Street.
Love you.
Okay, cool. First topic, mature skin.
Oh my God, yes.
You want to just talk about that? Okay, cool.
I can talk about it all day because it's right sitting in front of you.
Give me just another day. Hey, fellow beauty finders, what's up? It's Matthias Allen. Thank you for clicking on my new Monday makeup chat. So for those of you who have been following me on Periscope and Twitter and Instagram, you have all been dying to see this epic collaboration with epic makeup Melissa Street.
Hi,
I'm so excited
you're here!
Oh my God, yes! Oh my gosh, it's just surreal that you're sitting next to me on the couch.
Thank you.
Because I've been watching Melissa on Periscope for the last 3 months, and she is the smartest, most professional makeup artist in this business that I have ever had the privilege of listening to and learning from.
Oh, thank
so
you.
I had to get you on my Monday makeup
thank
chat.
Thank you, and back at you.
Thank
I
you.
I think that you are amazing. YouTube channel, like, God.
Oh.
I think you're doing so amazing for anyone out there who wants to learn how to do makeup the right way for this profession.
Oh,
definitely.
Thank you.
And you're showing such a variety. I absolutely adore that. I do. Because this is an artist, not just makeup. This is art.
Yes.
It is art.
It is
yeah.
art. If you do it creatively.
Yeah. I mean, I feel like what I do a lot in television and film is a lot of it is makeup, and it's transformation too, and it's getting actors and actresses in character and things like that, but there's a whole side that you are actually, that you do best as an expert, and it is art. It is it's a canvas, mm-hmm. and you're transforming, and it's mm-hmm. just, you watch it happen in front of your eyes, like just right there.
If you guys ever want to see one of my Fierce Face Friday episodes, I do a Fierce Face Friday transformation about once a month. And at Halloween time in 2015, I did one 3 times a week on my channel. So I have some great transformations. I'll put a link to that down in my description box. Today, I want to talk to Melissa, and I want to share with you guys who are fellow makeup artists who are learning about the business and wanting to get more professional advice. Mm-hmm. I want to talk about the difference between doing makeup on skin over the age of, let's say, 35, 40,
okay.
and doing makeup on skin that's younger and fresher
Definitely.
And taller
Definitely.
And more oily.
Definitely.
I mean, there are major differences,
there
right?
There are major, major differences, and it goes into, I think, not so much the color, like everyone's always like, oh, I can't wear the certain color, and I don't think that that's it. It's more about the heaviness that you wear.
And she's looking at me.
Yeah. No,
I'm like,
I mean,
I know, I pack it on.
No, because I've worked with very mature, very, very mature actresses, and they come from an older school world where they are like, oh, but we have a camera that's got the, you know, the hot lights. Yeah, and it's got the filters, and we don't have that, the soft lighting. That's gone. Bye-bye.
You mean like the 80s primetime soap stars?
Yes.
Who like love to
turbans.
Really pack it
yes.
on, right?
And they still want that because that coverage was amazing on camera, on those cameras with those kinds of lighting. We don't have that anymore. So you,
well, let
different.
Me ask you, let me interject.
Yeah.
I'm curious, okay? Because a lot of people are out there probably wondering, well, why? Why is it different? Why can't you put that much makeup on? And I really do have an honest question.
Okay.
What would that kind of makeup look like in today's
Okay.
field?
So
like,
so we happens? Film, in my world, everybody talks about HD, and HD, you got to get that out of your heads now, because HD is like 2K, if you will, okay? It's like, you know, very crisp, but we now film in things that are 4K, 5K, 6K. You're talking about, you know, hundreds of thousands of times HD.
Oh my God.
So forget HD, because HD is like, you know, HD is like whatever. It's absolutely
now. HD is like so beta, you guys.
It's so beta. It's so
only we will 82. Get that.
I know. It's so 82 because you had beta.
Yeah.
I did. And we remember when we could rent VHS or beta.
Yeah.
Oh, aging myself. Woo!
It's getting hot in here.
Yes. So that's what it is. So
it's 10 times more detailed now.
Yes.
So what happens when somebody
poor,
like...
Yeah.
Pores,
wrinkles, okay. And the heaviness, the brush strokes, anything that you didn't smooth out, any heavier contour lines, anything that you're trying to correct, because we like to do that still. We like to do contour and highlighting because it's a transformation. It's a thing. We're correcting certain things. Right. We want to make nose look smaller, you know, whatever.
Or making things happen that aren't already happening
exactly.
Naturally.
We want to do that. We still want to do that, but we have to do it minimally and with the right product and with this. This is when the techniques and the skills really come into play. The blending, all of that. It's no longer these like swipes and go on camera because it's just woo, you see crazy. And I know you guys see craziness because you watch the news, you watch whatever, you go, you know. So here's another really great tip, you guys. If you're interested in going and working in film and television, here's how I make sure that my foundations, all of them in my makeup kit, anything that I'm using, looks good in a 4K, 5K, or 6K situation on camera, okay? I take like a 10x mirror. I go and I find a mirror, 10x.
No, this is only 3.
This is only 3 on this side. It's only 3. But you want a 10x mirror. Get out all your foundations and your brushes, okay?
Oh, bigger than this?
Yes, more magnification.
You guys, this is going to be a really big challenge for you.
And what you want to do is how you can perfect your skills. And you can decide if the foundations and concealers and things that you're carrying in your kit look right on TV. If you apply them, put them on, do your brush strokes, blend them in, look at the 10x mirror. If you can see the makeup or you can see the brush stroke, then you know... brush, you got to work on the skill, and or that foundation concealer doesn't work, you need to go into a different realm
for that particular project.
For that particular project, right?
Because I know firsthand that there are full coverage makeups that I think look gorgeous on the skin,
right.
But and I've tried them on myself, but when I get up close, you can really see makeup sitting, but it looks great in a photograph.
In a photograph,
that's
right?
Different,
For television and film, and so it can also too be your skill. So don't just discard something that you have that's a product. Work and see if maybe I should be using a beauty blender, or maybe I should be using a sponge with this particular product because it's a heavier cream, or you know, whatever. Get a different kind of makeup brush instead, a foundation brush if you're, you know, and try those things out before you just, you know, start buying thousands and thousands of dollars worth of stuff. Just take some samples, go to Namie's or Nigel's or any of the department stores and ask them for some samples of stuff. You know,
and
don't spend too much money right off the bat and get that 10x mirror.
Yeah, don't always believe the hype.
Exactly.
Now, I have so many more questions to ask you,
okay. And
I don't want you to leave yet.
Okay.
So Melissa's going to be on another Monday Makeup Chat coming up very, very, very shortly. So you guys have got to please subscribe to my channel. Also, follow us both on Periscope, Instagram, and Twitter. I'm putting all of our names down in the description box. Melissa Street is an incredible makeup artist. She gives great advice, so you've got to follow her and watch her on Scopes. Also, follow me. I do a behind-the-scenes vlog every week, and I'm doing giveaways all the time, so please also follow me. And that's it. So for now, we're going to go. This Monday Makeup Chat is done. I am going to go get myself a 10K mirror and read myself a plenty.
Yeah, seriously. That's my tip for the day.
Thanks for the advice.
You're welcome, honey. Mwah.
I have stopped at one of my favorite booths in the entire... wait, hold on. Not episode. I'm not in a TV show. I wish I was in a TV show. Okay. Okay, hey you guys, what's up? I've stopped at one of my favorite booths at IMATS. I've stopped to say hi to my friend Eugenia Weston, owner, creator, and founder of Senna Cosmetics.